Mayor Nenshi, every province has experienced its set of challenges, especially in the last 6 months. How bad has it been for Canada's oil capital?
Very bad. So we're dealing with kind of four crises going on at the same time. And the first three are common to all of Canada, and then the fourth one exacerbates things here in Alberta and here in Calgary. So, of course, number one and most important, we have a public health crisis, and it's critical that we just keep people safe and alive as best we can. Number two, going along with that, is a mental health crisis. And that mental health crisis was always going on. You know, one in four of us will be touched by mental illness at some point in our lives. Every single family has a member who's dealing with mental illness. But when you add the opioid crisis and overdose and addiction to that, in addition to all the stresses of COVID, we have a giant mental health crisis. Number three, we're having conversations that are so long overdue, but critical conversations on whether we can say that our beautiful, inclusive, diverse country is also actively anti-racist, and if Black, Indigenous, and people of color are really experiencing what they need and deserve to experience in this country. So kind of all of North America is going through those three things. There are different hotspots in different places. All three of them are very hot in Calgary at the same time. But then the fourth one is the fact that we were already in the midst of an economic crisis as we go through the energy transition. It's been a very long crisis. It's been going on for nearly 6 years. And I think a lot of Canadians have not really understood the depths of that. So even before COVID, you know, Calgary went from having the lowest unemployment rate in the country for many, many, many years, from the lowest to the highest in less than 18 months. We went from having 0% vacancy in our downtown core, you can get an office for love or money, to nearly one in three buildings in downtown Calgary is empty in less than 18 months. So I don't want to make it sound like it's, you know, hell on earth over here. We were still called by The Economist the best city to live in the entire Western Hemisphere last year. The quality of life is high. Private wealth is high. People are living great lives here. But all of those things together are making it very challenging to think about what recovery looks like. And if we use the federal government's cliche, what it really means to build back better.
Mayor, you mentioned all of these challenges, and the Conference Board of Canada recently suggested that Alberta's GDP is going to shrink by 6.8%. As we go into this second wave, how much of a concern is it that businesses may not survive this second time around?
It's a massive concern. Now, to put things into context, we're in a massive global recession. And minus 6% GDP, well, most countries in Europe would be thrilled for that. You know, they're looking sometimes at numbers that are double that. But that said, the real problem here is how this has impacted storefront retail and how it's impacted small business. You know, after the flood in 2013, we saw lots of studies that say if a business closes during a natural disaster, some 40% of them will never reopen. And during the flood, we kept that to under 5%. But the flood was a week and then many, many months of recovery. This, of course, has gone on for a really long time. Now, in Alberta at the moment, almost all businesses have reopened. Certainly some have gone under, but that's part of the business cycle. Not all restaurants last for many, many years. But what I'm really concerned about is that some of them are barely hanging on now. If we have another large second wave, if we have further closures, we may see a lot of them just never reopen. And as the various support programs, from the wage subsidy to the commercial rent subsidy to our deferral of our property taxes, which expired on September 30th, as those things start to expire, I'm very concerned that businesses will find themselves in very tight cash flow crunches. So although they've been very resilient, restaurants have figured out how to work with social distancing and masking and so on, at some point, people are really aching for a return to those more normal revenues.
The recent federal speech from the throne did not address the Canadian oil and gas sector. Your thoughts on that, Mayor?
I'm not really concerned about what was or was not in the speech from the throne, but what I am concerned about is where we're moving forward. And it's really important for us to understand that as we move through the energy transition, as we move through diversification of the Alberta economy, that doesn't mean abandoning the Canadian energy sector, still, I believe, the largest industrial sector in the country. And, you know, I had a federal minister say to me just before COVID, if we had lost 125,000 jobs in southwestern Ontario or in the Saguenay in Quebec, this would be a crisis of national urgency. The federal government would think of nothing else. And so it's really important that we have that same kind of energy and focus from the government of Canada, from the government of Alberta, from municipal governments like mine, on what we do about the unemployment rate and about jobs in Alberta, both through supporting the energy sector, but also through real economic diversification. You know, Calgary remains one of the most educated cities on earth. The talent pool is deep and strong. There's lots of private capital. So there's a real opportunity now for governments to invest today in the kind of diversification that will pay huge dividends in the generations to come.
Specifically, what is it that you would like to see from the Alberta government, from the federal government?
You know, I think that we have the playbook. We know how to work our way through an economic recovery, and particularly in times where interest rates are so low, where monetary supply is plentiful. It really is about investing in the long-term plays that are going to make a difference. So that means the traditional infrastructure, absolutely. It means, you know, there's an opportunity to put people to work building transit, roads, clean water systems, and so on, flood mitigation here in Calgary. But it also means investing in the community more broadly. The number one thing right now is housing. We really have an opportunity in many parts of the country to actually end homelessness through a focused investment in housing, which is a lot of money, but not huge like the numbers we're seeing thrown around during COVID. Why not do that? Why not say that homeless shelters are not only areas where disease can spread, but they're areas that rob people of their dignity? So a big investment in housing would be a massive social win from the other governments. And then finally, a real thoughtful investment in economic diversification. The Alberta government in 1 year has gone from saying diversification is a luxury we cannot afford to huge billboards on the QE2 between Calgary and Edmonton saying diversifying our economy. But it's not enough to say it. It's not enough to put up billboards. It's about being focused and thinking about how we grow our film sector, our tech sector, our financial services sector, our tourism sector. And each of those require very specific strategies. And frankly, they all require talent. They all require immigration. They all require us to talk about how great it is here. And when people around the world just see the federal and provincial governments fighting, or people talking about fiscal reckonings and austerity coming, you can't attract investment in an environment like that. So we've got to get our act together. We've got to get our rhetoric sorted. And we have to make laser-targeted investments that are really aimed at building jobs going forward.
Are these the top priorities as you look ahead to the upcoming fall federal budget? Are deficits a concern at all?
I sure hope so. I sure hope these are things that we will see from both the federal and the provincial governments. Because certainly, we're going to need some belt tightening. Certainly, our budgets have to return to balance. But we also have to understand that we are in extraordinary times, and talk of future austerity is scaring away the growth that we need in order to be able to get out of this and build back better. But I will say that the idea of the investment in housing is something that the Federation of Canadian Municipalities has endorsed. And if the federal government is interested in a legacy, if they're interested in a big change, as we've heard so much about, I would suggest that is the one that if I were sitting in Ottawa, I would be putting my chips on.